Keep heading for thankful today that he hung on the cross and he paid a debt that I couldn't pay. I'm thankful today for that. Amen. I want you to listen to this song.
Satan just cowers to think of the power he lost when the cross had its day, and gone are the mornings when fear without warning would win and again have its way. Now when Satan reminds me of things I regret, I bring up Calvary, lest he forgets. High on the mountain of sorrow and shame, grace sighed my pardon as Christ took the blame. When I'm called to answer for my history, Calvary answers for me.
Aren't you thankful for the cross?
I am now under that beautiful wonder of grace that erased all my past. I feel the heartbeat of mercy inside of me, and now I have found joy at last. I live in freedom that chains cannot bind, and I won't look back on what I've left behind.
High on the mountain of sorrow and shame,
He's worthy tonight to be praised. That's what they came to do. That's what we came to do. We hope that's what you came to do. Because I'm telling you, I'm practicing up so when I get to heaven, I'm going to be ready to go. I think some people's waiting till they get there to praise him. But tonight, he's worthy to be praised. And you're praising him. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah. Man, I thank God tonight for Heartfelt and for Ryan. Ryan has helped me out many times. Back in December, we had 14 Christmas concerts, and the same thing. Last night, I got my throat was just, I don't know, real raw, feel raw. Like, and I said, well, if I can't sing tomorrow, I'll just get Ryan to sing my part. Back at Christmas, I was sick on the night before, and I just didn't feel right. And I got up the next morning, I woke up at 5 o'clock, and I was going, I just couldn't talk. I couldn't say nothing. And I thought, man, we had 3 Christmas concerts to do, and I thought, what am I going to do? So I called Ryan, and Ryan said, I've never sung no Christmas song up in front of people. He said, I've never did that. And I said, man, I need you. I was whispering to him. He has. And I called him, and I called all the churches, and then kind of whispered to them what was going on, that we weren't going to be able to do just the whole night of Christmas music. But we'd split up
because I'd already sent Ryan some songs to learn that he was going to take my place in March. And he got on the bus and he learned 10 Christmas songs on the way to the first concert and did a tremendous job. And I thank you, brother. So I had a free trip to Hawaii, and I knew I couldn't turn that down. So I sent Ryan about 20 songs to learn. Said, hey, can you fill in for me a weekend in March, 3 singings? He said, yeah. Well, I was in Hawaii the first night. I get a text from somebody at the singing. They said, well, after tonight, I guess you can go and drive the bus for him. He's out of that. I've got him. He ain't doing no more of my singing parts. I'm going to go over and get up here. We're glad to be here tonight.
He said next time he'd go to Hawaii and you could stay here.
I'm thankful for these guys tonight. Anybody tonight never heard us sing? Never heard us sing before? Anybody? Well, there's a few. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. This one here has been, these guys, I like to tell this because I was talking to Eric Bennett last weekend. And Eric was commending me on our group, and because we've stayed together, all these groups you'll see are making changes, and I've been thankful that these guys here have all been with me over half their life, and I'm thankful. Eric's 46, he's been here 24 years. How about Eric Harvison? He's been here 19, he joined on June the 15th, my birthday. And I always remember his day he started with us, and he's always told me that was the best birthday gift I ever got was the day he joined the Kills. He lives in Murfreesboro. How about Keith Worker? Would you make Keith Worker? You know, Faithful here, I don't know if I could do this without him. He and I have sung together nearly 40 years. And I'm thankful for that. He sings a girl's part.
Tenor.
Same thing. How about Paul? You make Paul welcome tonight. My name's John. That makes him all good. We're going to sing a lot of songs tonight from our new CD out there. But I like this song. We recorded it a couple of years ago. Listen as we sing. I'm rich, all because of Jesus.
I'm rich in faith and hope and love. I got more than my share. I'll be with me to my mansion just covering glory. Where I'm a rightful heir.
I'm a rat.
We have some special friends here tonight, and we want to sing this song, He's Got Glory. I like this old song. I'm thankful for my salvation.
I want to thank Jesus for the plan of salvation. Just to say, Lord, I love you, for you understand. I want to be
and his hand. like that song. I'm going to tell it on the way home.
Yeah.
I want Paul to come and sing a song. You look in John chapter 11. You read where Lazarus had laid in the tomb for 4 days. And Jesus came. And they rolled the stone back. And Jesus shouted out, "Lazarus, come forth." And Lazarus got up and walked out of the tomb.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to the day when he steps out on the cloud and he calls his children. He says, "Children, come forth. I'm going to walk out of that tomb just like Lazarus did." Amen. This is Paul sings this song. I love what the message says. Lazarus, come forth.
Heartbroken, tears falling, Martha found Jesus. She questioned why Lazarus had died. But she had thus spoken, her doubts were then silenced. He walked toward the body and cried, "Lazarus, come forth. Awake like the morning. Arise with new hope. A new life is born. Lazarus, come forth. From death now awaken. For Jesus has spoken, and death's chains have been broken. Lazarus, come forth."
The tomb was now empty. Martha stopped crying. Her brother now stood by her side. The Pharisees wondered about what had happened. How could one now live who had died? But the reason this story, it gives hope to so many.
I die to sin, I'm alive in Him. Hallelujah, He lives.
Now I am one of his own. Best of it, right? quickly, I'd like to tell you about some of the things that we have back there on the product table that just help us to get to the next church, the next place. We have some CDs back there. Most of what we've sung tonight is off of, there we go, the latest CD. It's called Room on the Rock, and like I said, most of what we've sung tonight is on that one. But any of our CDs are 15 apiece, earning 2 for $20. That's any of the regular CDs, the Christmas CDs, DVD, any of that stuff, 15 apiece, earning 2 for $20. Now, some of you may have a car that's missing a CD player.
Yeah.
And if you have a car that's missing a CD player, then that's okay. Because there's a little spot in there.
What's that for?
Huh?
What's that for? I use it to charge my cell phone.
You use it to charge your phone?
I do.
That's not what it's for.
Golly, I thought it was.
It's so you can listen to the Kellys. So we have some jump drives, some USB drives back there. And these are $30 because they've got
48 and 44 songs.
You can drive a long way on 48 or 44 songs.
Long way.
Yeah, you can listen to 48 on the way there, and then you can listen to 44 on the way back. You just have to listen, pick your favorites and listen to a couple of them twice, and it'll even out.
That's right.
Yeah, so those are 30. This one's 20, because it only has
20 songs.
20 songs, but it's got both our Christmas CDs on it. And so if Ryan had had one of these, he could have learned them before John called him. And so it's got all our Christmas stuff on there, and that's $20.
Yep.
We also have T-shirts. They say the Kellys on the front. And then on the back, it says spreading the word through song. And that is what we intend to do as we go from church to church, place to place.
But wait. There's more.
Now, if you wanted to go back to the table and get one of everything back there, how much would that cost?
$220.
Plus, you'd have to make several trips back and forth to get everything one at a time. Well, we'll save you the trouble. If you come back there and tell us you want one of everything, then for $100, which is less than half.
It's like 45%. Of course, I don't do math very well, but it's somewhere around 45%.
Yes, good. anyway, for $100, we'll put one of everything back there.
Plus?
In a bag. So all the CDs, the
jump
DVD,
drives.
Jump drives.
T-shirt.
Picture. We'll put Eric in there if you can fit him in the bag.
That's a big bag. Better double bag it.
Yeah. But also, we will give you 2 tickets to Wednesday night of the James D. Vaughn Festival, which is next week. Well, this week as in...
Yeah,
it's up. Wednesday.
Yeah, this is coming up Wednesday.
It's the 20 something. 26. It's the closest Wednesday to today. So we'll give you 2 tickets to the.
I don't do math very well, and he can't read a calendar, I guess.
We'll give you 2 tickets to the James D. Vaughn Festival. That's in Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, and that goes along with the $100 special. Now the tickets would be $20-something a piece.
Yeah, I think it's $24 a piece if you bought these tickets, and so you're getting them for free.
I mean,
this is
like one of those PBS deals where they're trying to raise money, and you get all this stuff that's worth like $500 for $100. It's you can't beat it.
All we need is a cute puppy dog that we can play some sad music with.
I'm done.